In the last video, we talked about how vectors can span a vector space or not span, and we had an example in which one of the vectors was redundant. This has to do with linear independence. So we say a bunch of vectors are linearly independent if the only way to write 0 as a linear combination is the trivial way. You can always get the 0 vector by taking 0 times b1 plus 0 times b2 and so on, plus 0 times bn. The question is, can you get 0 any other way? If you can't, then we say they're linearly independent. If you can, we say they're linearly dependent. Okay, so for example, if we're in R2, then the vectors 1, 0, and 0, 1 are linearly independent. Because if I have a linear combination that is equal to 0, 0, well, if I take a constant times 1, 0 plus another constant times 0, 1, I get first constant, second constant. And if that's the 0 vector, then A1 had to be 0 and A2 had to be 0. So these are linearly independent. On the other hand, the vectors 1, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 1 are linearly dependent because 1 times the first vector plus 1 times the second vector plus negative 1 times the third vector is 0. And you notice that out of this equation is related to the fact that the third vector is the sum of the first two. If you just put this on the other side of the equation, you get that 1 times the first plus 1 times the second equals the third. And this is related to a much more general property. Whenever you have a bunch of vectors, if they're linearly dependent, then one of the vectors can be written as a linear combination of the others. If they're linearly independent, then they can't. Of course, for this to make sense, for us to talk about the others, you have to have at least two vectors. So, for example, if you had 3b1 plus 4b2 plus 7b3 equals 0, you could put one of these on the other side of the equation, 3b1 plus 4b2 equals negative 7b3, and then you could express divide by negative 7, and you've got b3 as a combination of b1 and b2. So linearly dependent is like having redundant vectors, vectors that are already built from the other vectors. Now, a basis for a vector space is a collection of vectors that spans. There are enough vectors to go to explore every nook and cranny of V, and is linearly independent. That is, there are no extra vectors. Okay? That's the definition of a basis. And we'll explore how that works in the next video.